Hello, family. How are you? I hope you're having a good day. My family, I've had a good day today. Now, let's get right onto it. Now, as you all know, whenever there is a major event in the UK, or my family, practically, honestly, every single day at this point, the question that is always asked by members of the Roa Rota, who are supposed to cover the taxpayer-funded members of Britain's royal family, the number one question they always ask is, number one, is Harry coming? Or you know what, if he isn't coming, I wonder how Harry feels about missing this event. And you all know that my family, over the weekend, it was my family Remembrance Day in the UK, whereby my family soldiers who had lost their lives in the line of duty, my family, are being honored, have been honored, my family, and also remembered for the ultimate sacrifice they paid so that we all can get to enjoy the freedoms that we now enjoy. And we honor them and thank them for their ultimate sacrifice. Now, my family, basically, Prince Harry has broken his silence about Remembrance Day. And my family, UK media, must have thought that Prince Harry will not honor veterans. But my family, as you all know, that's impossible. That's impossible. Wherever Harry is, he will always be honoring veterans. Wherever he is, whether he is in the United States of America, Portugal, South Africa, Netherlands, my family, Dusseldorf, my family, Canada, wherever he is, Harry will always be honoring veterans. And before I read you the statement that Prince Harry has released, my family, which also can be able to see on Harry and Meghan's online sussex.com website. Before I read you all that, my family, let me just say this. The words of Carnival of so-called expert Richard Fitzwilliams, whereby even he thinks he knows what Harry feels, my family. He knows what Harry is thinking. My family, apparently, Carnival of so-called expert Richard Fitzwilliams, the same guy my family was called out, exposed for giving his opinions before the Oprah interview even aired, has said that Prince Harry will undoubtedly, be regretful on Remembrance Day. My family, and that Prince Harry and Meghan were notably absent from events this weekend, whereby they were not present for the annual Festival of Remembrance or joined the rest of the royal family for Remembrance Sunday at the Cenotaph. My family. And according to Carnival of so-called expert Richard Fitzwilliams, he said that on a poignant occasion such as Remembrance Sunday, Prince Harry will be regretful not being able to publicly mark the country's war dead in the UK with his family. Now, my family, let me just say this. It is clear that many things were taken away from Prince Harry after he stepped back as a senior member of the royal family. And what is utterly despicable is how we have seen a veteran, someone who spent the better part of a decade serving his country, the UK, in active, my family, military service, has been treated so appallingly, my family, in the country that my family he fought for, he served for. for many, many years. It's utterly just appalling. And my family, the thing is, this reflects badly on Britain. This reflects badly on Charles and Prince William, who are the ones who made the decision that Prince Harry was to be stripped of his military, my family, patronages. My family. You know? And they know how much that meant to Prince Harry. And clearly, it was done to hurt Prince Harry. It was done to cause Harry pain. And my family, the thing is, these events, really, that are being conducted, in as much as my family, you know, it's about the veterans. The thing is, my family, clearly, UK media, by mentioning the names of Harry and Meghan, and even saying that Prince Harry will be regretful for not being able to mark this event in the UK, my family, it is like UK media are constantly wanting Harry to regret leaving or fleeing the UK or stepping back as a senior member of the royal family. But thing is, in as much as the UK tabloids are trying to make Harry regret leaving, how can he ever regret it? How can he ever regret fleeing the UK when UK media spend all the time abusing him, his wife, his children, and then my family, they think they can make him ever regret fleeing the UK? How? 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 Yes, there are things that meant so much to Prince Harry. Even laying a wreath on Remembrance Day to honor soldiers, my family, who have sadly died in the line of duty. It meant so much to Prince Harry. It is sad that that was taken away. But remember Prince Harry's own words, my family. Now that he has a family, his own family to protect, he'll protect his family. So no matter what, his number one priority will always be his family. Meghan, Archie, and Princess Lilibet Diana. And I remember actually when Harry, you know, fled the UK, and that he and Meghan, my family, had moved to California, my family. I remember that Harry and Meghan, you know, it was my family around Remembrance Day in the UK. And Prince Harry and Meghan went to my family, you know, honor veterans in California. I remember that very, very well. It happened, you know, a couple of years ago. And they were attacked for doing it. Attacked for doing it. You know? And my family, when you are attacking a veteran who's honoring my family, his fellow veterans who sadly died in the line of duty, it's utterly despicable. Because my family, you came in there complaining, oh, you know what? You brought cameras to this you know, event whereby you are honoring veterans. But and yet, in the UK, my family, cameras are everywhere following members of the royal family. What they couldn't stand is that Prince Harry did not want tabloid cameras following him, Meghan, and his children. That's the real problem that most of the carnival of so-called experts really have. That Prince Harry is the one who wants nothing to do with them, and they can't stand it. Because if Harry was back there in the royal fold, my family, just imagine how more entitled UK media would feel over him, over his kids. My family, already even right now, even though Harry doesn't earn a penny of taxpayer money, we can see how obsessed UK media are with him. Now imagine if he was in the royal fold. Imagine if he was coming for my family a Remembrance Day event, you know, to the UK, back to the UK. Imagine the drama that UK media would be creating. Imagine the drama. My family, it would be excessive. And all these people who put Harry and Meghan through so much pain, all they care about is just exploiting both Harry and Meghan and even their kids. You know? And my family, as I said, it is easier to do so if Harry is in the UK than my family when he is in the US. And also, that's why you are seeing a desperate need by UK media for Prince Harry to be forced back to the UK, because UK media are desperate. The royals, who are funded by the taxpayer in Britain, my family, don't sell papers. And my family, royals, are not supposed to leave the, my family, gilded cage. And UK media want Harry back into captivity. My family, that's the life that they want for Prince Harry. A life of misery, you know, unhappiness. And my family being lonely. That's the life that they want for Prince Harry. My family, that fate will never ever be Harry's. This time, the firm and UK media will not destroy the spare. And even my family, Harry even mentions how my family, you know, after he and Meghan step back as senior members of the royal family, how my family, you know, Prince Harry had asked on Remembrance Day for a wreath to be laid on his behalf to honor veterans. And my family, he was told no by the palace. And that was an act of cruelty. Let me read you, my family, of that moment, of what happened, my family, back then. Because clearly, UK media want Harry to regret, you know, fleeing the UK. To regret ever stepping back as a senior member of the royal family. They want him to regret it. But then how UK media have been going about it, they've been going about it the wrong way. The wrong way. My family, I'll explain. But first, kindly, please, family, hear this, please, kindly. My family, what has been said by Harry on his memoir spare, my family, and I quote, "In all honesty, I hadn't been totally surprised when the palace cut ties. I'd had a sneak preview months earlier. Just before Remembrance Day, I'd asked the palace if someone could lay a wreath for me at the cenotaph, since, of course, I could not be there. Request denied. In that case, I said, could a wreath be laid somewhere else in Britain on my behalf? Request denied. In that case, I said, perhaps a wreath could be laid somewhere in the Commonwealth, anywhere at all on my behalf. Request denied. Nowhere in the world would any proxy be permitted or allowed to lay any sort of wreath at any military grave on behalf of Prince Harry, I was told. Now, my family, here's what is so hypocritical and exposes just how what the firm just wanted us to hurt Prince Harry. Do you know that Arthur Edwards, my family, who was treated and made disgusting comments about Harry's wife Meghan, someone who gets to wine and dine with Charles, someone who's invited to parties by Charles and Camilla. Do you know that my family, he was allowed to lay a wreath to honor veterans on behalf of my family, the readers of the Sun? They said, on behalf of the Sun tabloid. On behalf of the Sun tabloid. A veteran who served this country for the better part of a decade, my family, was told, you can't lay a wreath. But Arthur Edwards, my family, someone who is Charles and Camilla's cheerleader, my family, someone who wines and dines with Charles himself while wishing divorce upon Harry and Meghan, is allowed to lay a wreath on behalf of the Sun tabloid. a tabloid that spreads hate and division in the UK and all across the globe. My family. However, Harry has been told at the palace, no proxy will ever be allowed to lay any writ on behalf of Prince Harry. My family. Oh, because Harry said he's putting Meghan and Archie first. Or because he said he's protecting his family from the abusive, toxic tabloids by removing them from a toxic environment. My family, the firm and UK media know how important serving in the army has been to Prince Harry. They know how important it's been. And that's what they targeted. And they've targeted so many things that Prince Harry has cared about. And that shows you the level of cruelty that Harry and even Meghan have been subjected to by the firm, William and Charles, and the British tabloid media. So much cruelty. So much. You know? For example, during the Sandringham Summit, whereby Harry, my family, was having a meeting with William, the Queen, and Charles at the time, years ago, to decide his and Meghan's future. While Meghan, my family, the mom and the wife, and the target, the person that UK media have been trying to destroy, the person that William, Charles have been trying to destroy, all because they're jealous of Harry and Meghan's star power, was not allowed to be at that summit. During that summit, Harry said this, look, we don't care about the perks or whatever. All we want is to be allowed to keep security. That is important, my family. And despite, you know, Charles, William, and the Queen of Family agreeing, saying, yeah, you know what? It's important. They still, my family, stripped Harry, Meghan, and Archie off of their security. What the firm does is that they see, what is Harry afraid of? What is he afraid of losing? And that's what they target. Look what has been happening for years. Prince Harry loves Meghan and Meghan loves Harry. Look what the firm have been trying to target and continue to try to target, continue to try to destroy and take away from Prince Harry. They want him to, my family, lose his wife. They want to see Harry separated from the mother of his kids. They want Archie, Lilibet, to grow up in a broken home. Even though Prince Harry himself has said, as a father, as a husband, he wants to be the person who breaks that cycle of trauma, suffering, passed on from generation to generation, to my family, generation and family. From generation to generation. Harry said it ends with him. My family. But as you all know, when you're someone who is, you know, about to break, you know, cycles of, you know, curses, suffering, you will face pushback. And that's what Harry continues to face on a daily basis. My family. As someone who is committed to breaking, my family, generational curses, suffering, trauma. Harry faces so much pushback from those, my family, who exploit the trauma, dysfunction that exists in Britain's royal family and want it to continue. Because if it continues, they are able to make money from the sufferings that my family members of the royal family in the UK go through. And that's the UK tabloid media. And their actions have always been utterly evil and despicable and must be condemned strongly in the strongest terms possible. You know? So my family, when the firm and UK media know what Harry cares about, that's what they target. That's what they try to take away from him. My family, there can be no greater act of cruelty inflicted upon both Harry and Meghan than that. whereby when the firm knows their fears, that's what they go for. That's what they target to make Harry Meghan even more scared. And my family, that's just cruel. That's just cruel, extremely cruel. And my family, also let me, you know, now read you, my family, what Harry has said. So to Carnival also call expert Richard Fitzwilliams. Listen to me right now. Listen to me very, very well. There are things that Harry loves, and you know that he loves and cares for these things. Like how my family, you know, honoring veterans. You know how important it means to Prince Harry. And I know you want him to regret leaving the royal family because of those kinds of things that he cares so much about, these causes he cares so much about. But you know what? Every time you abuse him and his wife Meghan, you remind him why he and Meghan fled the UK. Every time you go after his kids, you remind him just why he and Meghan fled the UK. If you want someone to regret leaving, you treat them well. You say, I'm sorry about how I treated you and your wife and your kids. I promise I will never ever do so again. But UK media keep on abusing Harry and Meghan, and then they hope that they'll regret leaving. Oh, you know what? It is Remembrance Day in the UK. Harry must be regretful that he isn't here today. My family, I am sure Harry will love to be there for the veterans. But my family, what is more important to him is his family. It is Meghan. It is Archie. It is Lily Bedana. My family, in fact, even for those who watch the Heart of Invictus documentary, Harry himself said this, my family. He said that when he had children, my family, and even before he met Meghan, my family, he just said this, that if he did have kids, my family, he wants to be there for them. There is no way, my family, he was going to go on active, you know, military service to Afghanistan, my family, when he has kids at home. Harry was very, very clear on that in the Heart of Invictus, my family, because he wants to be there for his kids, to raise his kids, my family. My family, it is clear that yes, the military is important to Prince Harry, but my family, his family, Meghan, Archie, Lilibet, is his number one priority. And I know that's something that UK media don't like hearing, but that's the truth and nothing but the truth. Let me read, my family, what Harry himself has now said kindly. Harry's very, very own, my family, good, amazing words, my family, as he honors, you know, veterans, my family, on Remembrance Day, my family. And I quote, statement from Prince Harry, the Duke of Sussex. As we mark both Veterans Day and Remembrance Day, I reaffirm my lifelong admiration and appreciation for the service and sacrifice you and your families have made, both in times of conflict and peace. You have played a vital role in defending the values of liberty, freedom, and security. These values bind us together and have shaped you as leaders and role models. At a time of global uncertainty, remember the unity and purpose that defined your service, and do not hesitate to put that into action in your communities. And that same spirit should guide all of us in facing today's challenges. Your example and morality demonstrate that true power lies in our ability to unite and confront the obstacles before us. And that as you continue to serve, making valued contributions to communities, colleagues, households, and all those we love, my hope is that our communities will continue to serve your needs too, and that your contributions do not stop, because you no longer wear the uniform. I like that. I like that. Your contributions do not stop because you no longer wear the uniform. And the collective sense of appreciation for what you have done for your countries should also not stop either. Let today be a reminder that the true measure of gratitude is not in words alone, but in our actions and our ongoing efforts to build a world worthy of the sacrifices that those before us have made, and to protect it for generations to come. To all those who have served, past and present, I offer my deepest respect and thanks. Your service has made a lasting, positive impact for our communities, our nations, and our shared future. I am honored to stand with you. Wow. 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 To my fellow veterans, a message from Prince Harry, the Duke of my family, Sussex. I love it. I love it. I love it. Beautifully written. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful words from Prince Harry, the Duke of Sussex. Wonderful, wonderful words. I love it. I love it so much. You know? And my family, you know, I love how Prince Harry, you know, honors veterans. My family is just beautiful. Beautiful, 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 my family. Wherever he is, and whatever my family he does, Prince Harry is committed to supporting veterans wherever he is, my family. You know, in the US, in Canada, you know, Netherlands, my family, Dusseldorf, wherever he is, Harry is committed to supporting veterans. And I love that so much about him. That nothing of the farm or you committed to will ever stop him from doing good. My family, nothing. And I love that. I love that. I love Harry and Meghan's, my family, mantra. Show up and do good. You know? Show up and do good. And my family, it is just, my family, beautiful. It, my family, is just beautiful, my family. You know? And thank you to Prince Harry, the Duke of my family, Sussex, for my family, how he honors my family veterans. He's doing tremendously, you know, something good, and my family, something so, so beautiful. Something so, so, my family, you know, beautiful. I love what Prince Harry is doing, and may God bless him, my family, so, so immensely. Now, my family, there are those who will want Harry to regret leaving or fleeing the UK. And most of the people who want that to happen are those who my family bully him or abuse him or treat him and his wife and kids appallingly. And my family, as I've said, UK media are going about things the wrong way. You can't make Harry and Meghan regret fleeing the UK by bullying them, by abusing them, because that is what made them flee the UK in the first place. You can't make Harry regret fleeing the UK by abusing his wife, because of the abusive tabloids and how they were going after Meghan. Harry saw what was happening and took Meghan and Archie and fled the UK to protect his family. Harry did not want his wife Meghan, and does not want his wife, the mother of his kids, to end up like his mother. My family. So all these attempts are trying to make Harry regret leaving. You can't make him regret by reminding him every day of just why he fled the UK. You cannot. You cannot. You can't. You can't. You make someone regret leaving by treating them well, by saying sorry for all the pain you caused them, by apologizing to Harry, to Meghan, to their kids, to my family, you know, to the public even, for how Harry and Meghan have been treated appallingly. And until UK media and even senior members of the royal family are willing to say sorry for the pain they've caused Harry and Meghan, my family, honestly, Harry and Meghan are never going to regret fleeing the UK. Never. Every single day, the UK media attack Meghan or write negative things about her, which is practically every single day for the past 8 years. They can never, ever make Meghan ever regret fleeing the UK. Never. Never, ever, 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 never. And my family, you know, and whether Harry is wearing a uniform or not, my family, whatever he is, he'll always keep on doing good. And my family, that is fantastic. I love that so much. I love that so much. I love that so much. And 2K Media want to be the ones with the cameras following Harry Meghan around. You are never, ever going to get that ever. Ever. You'll never, ever be invited into Harry and Meghan's circle. Never. And the sooner the UK media understand that, the better. So right now, I want to hear your opinion on what we have discussed. May God bless Harry, Meghan, Archie, and also Lily Bedana and Doria Rugland, and all of you members of the squad at home. Hate never wins, love wins, and stay tuned to our next video. And to Richard Fitzwilliams, be content with the taxpayer-funded royals you have in the UK, and leave Harry and Meghan alone. At least even when you have an event in the UK, for once, don't ask, you know, what is Harry thinking? Where is Harry? For once, be content with the royals you have. Be content with the royals you pay taxes to fund. Be content with the royals, William and Charles, my family, who have been accused, rightfully so, of taking money from the very, very territories that they are supposed to represent. Be content with them and leave Harry and Meghan alone. Let them live and work in peace. And keep on doing good, my family, wherever they are. And may God bless them immensely. And so right now, I want to hear your opinion on what we have just discussed, my family. May God bless you all and stay tuned to our next video. Love you awesome forever. And to all veterans who have served, thank you for your service. Thank you for your service. Thank you for your service. Thank you so much for your service. Stay tuned to our next video. Love you awesome forever. And may God bless you all. Hello, members of Let's Go Family TV. First of all, I want to say thank you for all your support that you give us to our channel. We don't take it for granted that you support this channel. I want to say thank you from the bottom of our hearts for lending out your support and fighting against injustices, supporting Prince Harry and Meghan, showing them love. Love will always triumph over evil, and for that I say thank you. Good will always prevail over bad. Thank you so much for all your support. Thank you so much for joining this community, this amazing community of Zesco Family TV. I love you so much, family, from the bottom of my heart, and I wish you all the best. May you have a great, great day. And I hope that you enjoyed this video and learned a lot of things. With that and so much more, stay tuned for our next video. Leave a comment below, like, and subscribe. Love you, family, always and forever. Sayonara.